in terms of feasibility of earthquake impact assessment using automatic sentiment and topic analysis on the case of the 2023 Morocco event. Diana, please, thank you.
Thank you very much for the introduction. And, well, before going to the main topic, consider that I was invited to commemorate the 50th and the 50th anniversary of the EMC. I consider necessary to explain how we'll start cooperating. Then, this is the structure. This is the structure of the presentation for each of the sections. I'm going to use elements from the different cases on which we have cooperated. By these days, all of us, we use any sort of social media platform. For instance, today I posted about this presentation on LinkedIn. That's why this presentation will be interactive, so I'm going to ask you to scan this QR code and tell me which social media platform do you use. Don't worry, it doesn't collect any personal data, and the answer will be anonymous. I don't have what?
None of them.
None of them? Ah, I'm sorry, I forgot. I'm going to need to open this.
It's the number
I should open it. Okay. Okay, thank you for those who answered. I'm sorry for the delay. Okay, we see Instagram, Twitter, now X, and YouTube. Now, the daily traffic of the social media every day is huge. But when an earthquake or any other extraordinary event happens, the social media platform explodes. And unfortunately, there are also crowdsourcing platforms like Last Wake Up, like Earthquake Network and MyCheck. For those who doesn't know what is Last Wake Up, Remy explained a bit. It's a multi-channel information system that is comprised by an app, also by a website, and for a Twitter Quakebot. And these three send and collect data from users. So I'm going to ask you to now answer, which of these platforms do you use to report an earthquake threat?
It doesn't change,
yes. No. I wonder why. Alternative source of data. On the 22nd of March 2020, an earthquake struck the Croatian city of Zagreb. One person died, 26 became injured, and two more people died during cleaning operations. What was so special about this earthquake that it happened during the recently lockdown imposed by governments to stop the spread of the COVID-19. That's why the project was not able to deploy an on-site mission, and I was in charge of georeference the buildings with data. For that, I used Twitter, now it's Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. However, before this earthquake, for the case of the Albania earthquake, I managed to identify that in social media, you can find information about search and rescue activities, damages in buildings, seismic information, emergency actions, arrival and distribution of humanitarian aid, solidarity messages, and solidarity actions. However, for the case of Zagreb, my task was georeference damages in buildings. And for that, what I did is starting georeferencing landmarks like the cathedral. I'm going to use better this pointer. The cathedral, in this case, to georeference this damage, I look at the building behind, that is the building of the Croatian Society of Fine Arts. In this case, what I did, look at the name of the street, and in this case, I contact the photographer of Reuters. In that sense, I managed to georeference some buildings. I also validate the location of the buildings, looking at Google Street View. Although by that time it was not yet updated, the images there were not inundated, at least for the case of Zagreb. And following this method, I managed to identify that the most affected area in Zagreb was the city center. And it was possible to identify other damaged buildings around the city. By September 2020, we published preliminary results about our research, extracting information about the progress of recovery around the 10th anniversary of the earthquakes in Latvia, in Haiti, in Chile, and in Canterbury. When we published the results, was when Remy and Laure from ENC contacted us in Newcastle University to see which method we have been using for extracting information from these text data. And since that, we started to cooperate until the day of today. Now, with this cooperation, we managed to plot the intensity field reports submitted by users. And we managed also to georeference additional damages in buildings. And regarding the operation, and regarding the question, the initial question on Remy and Laure, we were already looking at techniques used by other researchers to extract information from data from social media. In this case, I think it was for the Hurricane Sandy. So these other authors identified sentiment analysis and topic model. Now, why do they use these methods? The data that you get from social media or comments from last users are what is called unstructured data. Then you need techniques like sentiment analysis, which is a natural language processing technique, a branch of the artificial intelligence that use machine learning algorithms, to classify the data into polarities or just classify as unrelated. Which kind of comments are classified as positive? Those related to solidarity messages or a successful rescue operation. Negative, those that report casualties and injuries, and also damages in buildings. Neutral are those that report intensity or magnitude. This technique, sentiment analysis, has been mainly used in customer review of products and places. And I use it in the case of social media platform for emergency response assessment. But with data from LASCOEA, I use it for impact assessment. What happened? The impact of an earthquake is not the result only of the magnitude, it's the result of the implementation of disaster management policy before. So people who are located in areas affected by earthquake had the right to express their satisfaction or satisfaction with the results of the implementation of those policies that are reflected in the impact of the earthquake. Now, there is another two techniques, but here is, I'll mention one, that is the topic analysis. Here you can see a list of topics. Those lists was identified by in the data set of the post on Twitter for the Albanian earthquake. And the idea is to detect the frequency of those topics in the comments of the users. There is another technique that is topic modeling, in which you just give the text data to the algorithm and the algorithm define the topics that it finds. Now, to classify the data manually, you need to define some rules. Everything that make the impact less, to reduce the impact, is considered positive, and what make the emergency response easier is considered positive. Everything that implies a higher impact or makes the emergency response more difficult is classified as negative. And neutral is considered sending information, the magnitude, the describing objects are moving. Now, I'm going to give you some examples of comments classified into each polarity. So, I'm going to ask you to focus on some keywords that help you to define the polarity. So, for instance, positive, no damage, no one got injured. In the case of negative polarity, it describes strong shake. This is expression of distress, very high intensity. In the case of neutral comments, it just informed where the earthquake was felt, which object were shaking. Unfortunately, in the case of comments that contain special characters, very typically in Spanish or in French or in Portuguese or in Arabic, some computers don't have those forms, so unfortunately that data is missed for the classification. There are sometimes still some unrelated data from some users that misuse the app. So I explained you the rules and I give you examples. So I'm going to ask you to help me to classify one of the comments related to the Maro Pueblo. So I felt my bed shaking and left the house safely in Morocco. That 6.9 earthquake was no joke. There is another aspect in sentiment analysis. You can make the classification at comment level, that is at document level, based on the main polarity. That is sentiment analysis at the document level, in this case at comment level. Thank you to those who participate, and now. This sentiment analysis can be done at sentence level. If you see, there are at least three sentences here. Then I'm going to ask you to classify, to allocate, in this case you can select more than one, and check if of the sentence. And it's supposed that when you classify at sentence, the classification of the polarity should sum at the end one. Yes, it's like a percentage. Okay. Then these are two cases or two levels for the sentiment analysis. Now, these are the topics that we identify for topic analysis. These are the rules. So I'm going to give you some time to read it because we are going to classify the same comment at topic. We're going to do the topic analysis of this comment at sentence and at comment level. Okay, in this case, when you do the topic analysis at document level, at comment level, again, you can select in this case only one topic, the main one. Now, please do the same, but at sentence level, for the three sentences that we observed. Okay. And this is more or less the process for the classification. Now, here we have some example of what is classified as building damage. Again, I'm going to ask you to focus on some keywords. Distress. Emergency response. Casualties. The description of objects moving. And seismic information. Now, how is the complete process? The complete process is last quake app users, they submit their comments and images through the app. EMC storage the data, they provide us with the Excel file or CSV file. For the case of the Aegean earthquake, I translate all the comments to English. The rules, specification rules were defined, similar to those classification rules that you already saw. And the result of the classification of the polarity is published in the repository of Newcastle University, is public. And I also make a spatial plot, the spatial distribution of the polarity. Now, my initial hypothesis was that those places on which comets have negative polarity are the most impacted places, and those when you see comets with positive polarity are less impacted. What you can see clearly is that most of the comets usually are clustered around the epicenter. For this case, I analyze the polarity according to the intensity reported by the user, and you can see that higher the intensity reported, more negative the polarity of the comet. However, if you notice, regarding significant number of comets, I will consider until the intensity reported 7, because the other higher intensities, the comets are very few. Now, for the topic analysis, the process was the same. The difference is I plot the spatial distribution of the topics, and I have an epicenter, and here you can see the topics of the comets in the map. For instance, a tsunami effect, damages in lines, and building damage. So the sentiment analysis can tell you where there is something wrong, while the topic analysis can tell you exactly what is wrong. If there is a damage in buildings, if there is effects of the tsunami, or is damages in the lifeline. For this case, I also did the analysis of the topics addressed according to the polarity, according to the intensity reported. You can see that the highest frequent topic is intensity. That is not a surprise, because last week up is an app to report intensity. What you can notice is that topic is followed by solidarity messages, damages in buildings, tsunami effects, and damages in lifeline. What you can see also is higher the intensity reported, the number of topics addressed in the comments are less. For the previous cases, I did the classification manually in polarity. But for the case of Albania, we tried something different, and with the support of the Cardiff Natural Language Processing Group, they used two transformer-based language models, which is called algorithms, and one is multilingual, so detect the polarity in all the languages. The other one, the Roberta, needs that the comments will be already translated to English. The accuracy of Twitter TXLM was 0.48, that's acceptable. In the case of the Roberta was 0.86, that's very good. And what I call accuracy is the percentage that the classification done by the algorithm match the classification done by humans, because artificial intelligence still needs the humanity. Another analysis that is possible to do is the keywords using word clouds. However, it is more useful when you do the classification at sentence level, otherwise you will see that there are expressions that appear in the negative polarity, but also in the positive, although the frequency is less. So that helps you to identify the keywords that help you to teach the algorithm what should be classified as negative, as positive, or as neutral. For the case of Albania, I also plot the spatial distribution of the polarity, this one in Albania, Tirana, and Florence. And in the case of this building that I named like 7C, it reported a weak intensity, but the comment have a lot of distress. That's why it's classified as negative,